I'd like to pose a question. Why are you here? Meditate on that question for just a few moments. Why are you here? Somewhat a tough question, isn't it? And like many other women, the reason why we're here is not too clear. We don't really understand our purpose for being on this earth. Our life doesn't have a whole lot of value or meaning to it. We get up in the morning and we go to work and to provide for our family, and we raise kids, and we come back home and we go to sleep, and we get up just to do it all again, just to repeat it. It's a weary and a tiring cycle. And I know that cycle all too well, where you're not thriving, you're not blooming, you're not flourishing, you're just simply surviving day to day. I started having my kids at 18 years old, so by the age of 21, I had already had 4 kids. And we struggled. I mean, the struggle was real. There were summers with no water, there were winters with no heat. There were times when I couldn't go to work because I didn't have a babysitter, so we did live off the government. And then the times that I could go to work, I was making minimum wage. I had no certificates or no degrees, so we never really got above average. We stayed below the poverty level. The struggle was real. We lived this type of life for a good 15 or so years. That cycle, that tiring, vicious, insane cycle, until I finally, a few years ago, I was tired. Y'all, I was spent. I didn't know what else to do. I didn't know who else to call. I was in this pit, this deep, dark pit, all alone by myself, with my back against the wall, knees to my chest, folded all together, almost in a fetal position, spent, tired. And I asked God, I said, you know what, God, if I happen to lay down tonight and not wake up, I wouldn't be mad at all. So in a cool kind of way, I was asking God to take my life. I was that tired. The next morning I woke up, he didn't take my life, but he did put this yearning and this desire inside of me for him. So I had this really tough pull to grab my Bible. I grabbed that Bible, a Bible that I had over 25 years and probably read in it maybe a total of 10 times. But I grabbed that Bible and I began to read it. From Genesis on, I began to read that Bible. I began to feed my spirit with the holy word of God. I began to watch television shows and messages from people like Joyce Myers and Priscilla Shirer and Creflo Dollar and T.D. Jakes. I began to, instead of listening to the R&B and the rap music that I was used to listening to, I started listening to praise and worship music. I started spending time alone with God, just talking to him. I mean, instead of saying, thank you, God, for today, thank you for waking me up, oh, God, thank you, I love you, and all that, I actually set aside holy time, dedicated, committed time, to talk to him, to spill my guts out, to let him know where I was coming from. And that's when he grabbed my hand, he grabbed me up, and he took me in what I like to call my life's twister. He grabbed me up with everything I had there, and he just started twisting it, and threw out all the other stuff that wasn't necessary, all the detrimental stuff, all of the hazard relationships, all of the bad habits. He threw them out, and he replaced me in a place where I could sit and be with him, dedicate time with him, and do his work. So now I am living a life that's full of purpose, led by the Holy Spirit. I am walking in my destiny, and I know it. It is clear what it is that God has for me to do. But I had to get my heart and I had to get my thoughts on the things above. God says in his love letter to us, that Bible, in Jeremiah 29 and 11, the Creator, our Creator, our Father said to us, I know the plans that I have for you, and they're not disastrous plans. They are to prosper you. They are for a future and hope. I'm going to repeat that. Our Creator, the Creator of this earth and of you and I, He told us, I know the plans that I have for you. And they're not disastrous plans. They are plans to prosper you, to flourish you, to bloom you, for you to have abundance, for you to have hope and a future. That's some good stuff. Now, I know you've heard that verse plenty of times before, but many people leave out the verses that comes close after that. Verse 12 says, I'm going to read it for you. Verse 12 says that in those days when you pray, I will listen. And then verse 13 says, if you look for me wholeheartedly, you will find me. That means so you turn your hearts and your thoughts over to God, go seeking for him. And when you find him, you're going to find your reason for being here. You're going to find your purpose. And then you will begin to walk in that thing. You will begin to walk in glory. You will begin to walk in joy, in happiness, in a meaningful, valuable life. And so I challenge you yet again today to take that verse, a set of scripture, Jeremiah 29:11-13. Write it on a sticky note. Write it on an index card. Download a picture of it. Download the verse and recite it to God throughout your day. Again, when you recite God's word back to him, you put yourself in a position for your prayers to be answered, because he said in his word that he watches over his word to perform it. So when you pray his word back to him, you're opening yourself up for those blessings. Hallelujah. So then, that is a challenge. And also, when you're ready to go deeper into finding your purpose, contact me. Call me, reply to this video or this email. Go to the website and sign up for your complimentary one-on-one session so we can sit down and I can use the wisdom that God has given me, the spiritual wisdom and the experience from my life, to help lead and guide you into your pathway for purpose. All right, so that is my time today. Look for your video tomorrow, your third video from this three-part series, and it is called Where Do I Start? So yesterday we talked about your identity being defined in Christ Jesus. Today we talked about finding God, seeking God for your purpose, and tomorrow we're going to talk about where do we start. God bless you on today. I love you. God loves you. Have an awesome day. Bye-bye.